university should have procedures in order to handle this. This situation is divided. You have the human respect issue of using the term water buffalo. You also have the censorship issue of the students picking up all of the newspapers. I think that students need to realize that in order to get things working in the system, you have to work within the system.
It wasn't a story about the Holocaust, Julian, it was an ad. And there's a very significant difference between a story or a column and an advertisement. It was the judgment of our media board, strongly supported, I think, by faculty and student sentiment, that the paper behaved irresponsibly, accepting such an obviously false and inflammatory ad. If there were an opinion expressed with which, on an issue like that, I would, of course, disagree mightily, I think the best response is rebuttal by other opinions. And there would have been surely at Georgetown.
Experience that these women have. It wasn't just a racial remark. It was also a remark that demeaned their womanhood, their black womanhood. If these women are like others on white college campuses, they also have a history of rejection by black males, whom they say are interested only in how women look, in sex, or in interracial dating.
Blown up the way it was. And also, I want to add that I thought that the student put it very well in saying that it's a question of respect. And also, I think it's very important that when we talk about freedom of speech, we are clear about what we're talking about. I don't think racial epithets are covered by freedom of speech.
Dr. Romero.
We're looking at race and class in America. To me, it's not simply a question of words. I think it is dealing fundamentally with race relations, and I would go back to what you have said, and that is that contradiction between the First and the 14th Amendment, individual rights versus group rights. Fundamentally, water buffalo, we're talking about racism in America, and that's what we need to put on the table and discuss frankly.